Hello, Transurfer and the Transurfing Curious. My name is Renee Garcia, and this is Transurfing TV, y'all. And today on Transurfing TV, we're going to be talking about one of the energy exercises that Vadim Zeeland gives in this bitchin' book right here. You know what I love about this book is that even if when you read it, you can still, like, a couple years later, go back and open to a random spot, find something that really seems like wasn't even there before. It's really amazing. It's just such a vast pool of knowledge. I mean, it runs so deep that I think it's pretty incomprehensible to the human mind on the first go around. So you could always go back to it. It's kind of like the Bible. You just like open up and read something and get something new each time. It's pretty amazing. So today we're going to be talking about your protective shield. Now, I'm going to read a little bit of the book because, as you can see here, I had kind of a challenging time trying to draw this out. I was like, man, how? Okay, so no, erase, drew it again. So I'm actually going to read it from the book, and then you can see my little crappy illustration here as a reference. And I will get to, obviously, the end of what I'm going to read and state what Vadim Zeeland states, that this is not a protection from energy vampires or pendulums, but this is a way to replenish your energy levels once you have acknowledged that an energy vampire or a pendulum has hooked you, and you do what you need to do as a transurfer, drop importance, allow the pendulum to fall through, but your energy level's still a little bit depleted after an experience like that. So it's this exercise that can get your energy levels back up pretty quickly. And remember, as Vadim Zeeland states countless times in the book in a variety of different ways, that you need adequate energy levels to properly and successfully transurf. This is kind of why I feel when I first found transurfing, I was like on cloud nine, everything looked good. I was super like, my worldview had completely transformed. And I'm like, oh my God, this is fucking amazing. I can't believe it. And then I would seemingly wake up like a week later or 2 weeks later in my old mindset, and I would be like, whoa, I don't understand what happened. Where did my transurfing brain go? Well, my energy levels weren't adequate enough to hold that transurfing worldview and to be efficient and effective within the modality, right? I would, my energy levels would go down. Again, just like what I was talking about, energy vampires or pendulums, being unaware, and I would get hooked. I wouldn't have any protection against that stuff happening. My energy levels would be depleted, and by then I would sort of lose myself to that external script and forget about transurfing and forget about doing something like this, right? It was only until I started really paying attention to what was affecting me energetically and doing things to protect myself from energetic loss that my transurfing game really took off. So this is a valuable lesson. I will be honest, this isn't one that I do, or this isn't one, I have done something similar and I'll talk about what I've done. I really enjoy the Vadim Zeeland meditations. If you're not familiar with those, we have a playlist on this channel. You can definitely take a look. This is a really good way to keep your energy levels up, to set sort of the intention that you are not going to allow yourself to be depleted. And when you do feel like your energy levels are going down, that you do something, you wake up, I see myself, I see my reality, my energy levels are down, and then you go about correcting that energetic imbalance so you can continue on with your transurfing game, because that's what it's all about. Before I get started on the lesson and this little mess of illustration here, please remember to join us on the International Transurfing Institute Facebook group. It is lit. Reality 2.0 on Teachable down below. Check it out. Follow me on Instagram, reality_transurfing. And don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment on this video. Let us know what you do to keep your energy levels up. If you have found a sufficient way in doing so, I'm definitely interested in hearing what you have done. So, okay, let's get to it. I'm just going to read, it's about a page and a half here, and then we will run through a brief, you know, synopsis of what I've read, and you can take this lesson with you today and maybe try it out and see that it does. So when I said that I haven't done it, I actually, a couple of days ago, I started doing this and I immediately felt exactly what he was talking about. So the key here is, and I'm not going to read this part, don't overthink it, right? If you don't feel it right away, pretend that you feel it. And that's more than enough. And this is exactly what my experience was. As soon as I, you know, got into pretending that I felt it, then I sort of felt exactly what he was talking about. And that's what I'll read right now. You can develop and maintain healthy energy levels by regularly performing the following exercise. It is very simple and does not take much time. First, stand in a comfortable, relaxed position. Breathe in and imagine a flow of energy coming out of the ground, entering the perinea region and moving up the spine, roughly at the distance indicated above, exiting the head and extending upwards into the sky. Now breathe out and imagine that a flow of energy is descending from the sky. The flow of energy enters the head, moves along the spine, and passes out and down into the ground. You do not necessarily have to have a sense of the physical flow of energy. It is enough just to imagine it. With time, your sensitivity will develop and you will learn to feel the energy moving. Next, imagine both currents moving towards each other simultaneously without crossing, each in its own meridian. So kind of like a freeway, two cars going in opposite directions. At first, practice on the in-breath and out-breath. But after a while, try to let go of tying the flows of energy to the rhythm of your breathing. You can quicken the flow, imbuing it with power using the strength of your imagination, intention. Now imagine that the ascending flow exits the body and pours downward over the top of your head in a fountain shape. Right? Similarly, the descending flow exits the body and passes in the opposite direction, directly under the feet. You now have two fountains, one above you and one below you. Mentally unite the spray of both fountains so that you are enveloped inside a sphere of energy. Then draw your attention to the surface of your body. Feel the surface of your skin and extend the same feeling out into the sphere like a balloon that gets bigger when you blow into it. Isn't that awesome? When you mentally inflate the surface of your skin, the sphere created by the meeting fountains of energy become firmly established. You should remain relaxed throughout the exercise and avoid creating tension by trying too hard to feel the energy physically. Do not worry initially about not being able to get a physical sense of the central meridians. You are so used to them that you have stopped feeling them, just as you no longer feel any other healthy inner organ. From time to time, practice regularly, concentrating your attention on your energy currents, and you will soon come to sense them physically. Perhaps not the same immediacy as touch, but tangibly nonetheless. This is energy training. By joining the currents into a sphere, you create a protective shield around your body. By extending the surface energy of the body into the sphere, you strengthen the shield until it acquires a stable condition. This exercise is invaluable. Firstly, the shield protects your energy from being undermined. Secondly, by training your energy levels, you cleanse the subtle meridians. The blocks that prevent the flow of energy dissipate, and the holes in the aura that cause energy to be lost close up. This is a gradual process. Nothing is going to happen just like that. On the other hand, you will save yourself from constantly having to seek the assistance of psychics and reflexologists, being able to restore the healthy circulation of your energy independently. You should be aware that of itself, your energy body will not protect you from vampires and pendulums, because the freeloaders pump energy by adjusting their frequency to your frequency. When a pendulum tries to hook into its prey, the victim's state of balance is undermined. In this moment, you have to wake up and reduce importance if you are to defeat the pendulum. Then the muscles will relax, your energy levels will restore to a state of balance, and the pendulum will fall through into emptiness. If you are not swaying, the swaying pendulum cannot take your energy. Conscious awareness is essential if you are to develop control in moments when you involuntarily lose your inner balance. Okay, woo! So that's kind of a lot there. What I did not read is that the human body is surrounded by an invisible energy field called the aura, right? We all know what the aura is, or we've all kind of heard of the aura. Maybe we don't really know what it is. I'll admit, it's not something that I necessarily think about. But you definitely gain a sense when your aura gets penetrated, right? When your aura is penetrated, you feel as though you're being like softly violated. This could be somebody stepping in too closely, invading your personal space. This could be something happening within your personal space where you feel a sense of fight or flight. This could be you losing yourself into the external script, right? Something happening outside of you that captivates you and like takes you in or out, I guess, of the center screen. So this idea of managing your energy body, feeling the surface of your body, setting the intention to use this dormant power, practicing this exercise that we just spoke of, and expanding this energy to flow to happen simultaneously with your breath, and sort of gaining a more solid connection with your aura, is a very effective way, and again, cleansing the meridians, as Vadim Zeelan talked about, and replenishing your energy levels when they have been depleted by vampires or pendulums. So another way that you could get this going and really cleanse your meridians out is one of the Vadim Zeelan meditations. This is one that I personally love. And again, if you have not checked out these meditations on this channel, they're pretty awesome. But it's essentially the same exercise. So just as Vadim Zeelan stated that you have, you know, this energy flow coming out of the ground, into your feet, out the top of your head, and then with your breath out, you're withdrawing energy from the sky and bringing it external down to the ground and then back up out, right? So again, expanding this energy flow to happen simultaneously, like a two-way freeway, two cars going in opposite directions on a freeway. So the other exercise that's very similar to this, and this is really powerful. So if you don't get a sense of this one, like if you try this and you're like, I don't feel anything, do this one that I suggest and you will see this one is extremely powerful. So the best scenario to do this in is when you're walking. And even better than that, if you could do this when you're out in nature, this is the one that I do when I'm out hiking or somewhere where there's, you know, a forest where there's a lot of nature and greenery and it's quiet. So what I do is I imagine that out of my solar plexus, I have like a stem coming out, and there's two channels, energetic channels, one that goes up out of the center here, one that goes up, shoots up to the sky, and then one that comes out the back here, and then that one goes down, right? So when you're walking, you sort of gain this feeling. It's kind of like feeling the plate, right? It's something very similar. You can feel almost, you know, a push and pull sort of sensation, and again, an extension coming out of the solar plexus. And then you turn these dials, essentially. So they're originally just kind of jetting out, and then you turn the one in front up and the one back down, and you will feel like some sort of force that sort of makes you stand more erect, gets you feeling kind of this charge, like charged up. It's really fascinating. And for me personally, I've experienced all sorts of weird things in this state, like animals being attracted to me, people kind of popping up out of nowhere and starting a conversation, having ideas, all kinds of interesting little phenomenon going on. And I think it's simply because those central meridians are activated and the energy flow is getting cleansed, right? You're cleaning out your energy, and just like the plate, you're sort of activating yourself. So again, if you try this one, you know, doing the breath in and the breath out and the fountains of energy stemming from the top of your head and the bottom of your feet and forming a force field or a shield around you. If you don't necessarily gain a sense of that one, do this other technique. And it's intense. Like you can definitely, definitely, definitely feel it. So let me know your thoughts, everyone. And I wanted to ask, has anyone tried the Vadim Zeland meditations? And if so, what's your favorite? What has your experience been with them? How have they helped you in your replenishing of your energy levels or your reality creation practice? And yeah, just talk about it. I mean, a lot of people don't really know that this is a thing. Vadim Zeland has his own meditations. So I'm curious to hear your thoughts on how they have worked for you. And if you haven't tried them, check them out and come back and comment, or let's start a conversation in the Facebook group about the Vadim Zeland meditations. Thank you so much for watching my video, everybody, and see you tomorrow. Bye, guys.